Good morning students. In this class I am going to discuss with you about xylaria. Classification of xylaria. It comes under the class Ascomycetes, order Siphonales, family Xylanaceae, example xylaria. Occurrence. Xylaria is a common saprophytic fungus which grows on decaying wood deadlocks. It is commonly called as dead man's finger. Classification of xylaria. Xylaria comes under the class Ascomycetes, order Siphonales, family Xylanaceae, example xylaria. Occurrence. Xylaria is a common saprophytic fungus which grows on decaying wood deadlocks. These are commonly called as dead man's finger. The plant structure of xylaria. The plant body is the mycelium, which is septate in condition. The mycelium produces a finger-like structure called as the stroma. The stroma is heliotrophic in condition, that is, it grows towards the sunlight. The stroma may be branched or unbranched in condition. If the stroma is branched, it appears like horn of the deer. The plant body of xylaria is mycelium, which is septate hyphae in condition. The mycelium produces the finger-like structure called as the stroma. This stroma usually grows towards the light, hence it exhibits the heliotrophic condition. These stroma are branched or unbranched in condition. The branched stroma appear like horn of the deer. Xylaria reproduces both by asexual and sexual method. Let us move towards the asexual reproduction taking place in case of xylaria. Xylaria reproduces asexually by the formation of the spores called as the conidiospores, which are produced on the surface of the stroma in chain form, which are liberated by wind, and after falling on the suitable substratum, they starts to germinate and produces the new mycelium. Asexual reproduction in case of xylaria takes place by the formation of the spores called as the conidiospores. These spores are produced in chain at the tip of the stroma, and after the cutting and falling of these on the suitable substratum, they starts to develop into the new mycelium. Sexual reproduction. During sexual reproduction, the mature stroma produces a number of flask-shaped structure called as the perithecium. This perithecium is called as the fruiting body or ascocarp of xylaria. Perithecium are developed at right angles to the stroma. During the sexual reproduction, xylaria produces the fruiting body called as the perithecium. These fruiting body are flask-shaped structure and they are produced at right angles to the stroma. Structure of the perithecium. This perithecium is flask-shaped structure with an opening at the apex called as the osteole. The outer covering of the perithecium is called as the peridium. Towards the osteole, a number of hair-like structures are present called as the periphyses. Towards the base of the perithecium, on the inner side of the peridium, a number of club-shaped structures are present called as the ascus, which comprises of 8 ascospores in it at maturity. In between the ascus, there are hair-like sterile structures are present called as the paraphyses. After the release of these spores from the ascus, they starts to germinate and produces the new hyphae. The structure of perithecium. Perithecium is the fruiting body in case of xylaria, which is flask-shaped structure with an opening at the tip called as the osteole. It is having the outer covering which is multilayered in nature called as the peridium. Inner to the peridium at the basal region, it produces the sac-like structure called as the ascus. Ascus comprises of 8 ascospores in it, and these ascus are separated by the sterile hair-like structure at the base of the perithecium called as the paraphyses. when the ascus attains the maturity, it comes out from the perithecium and bursts out and releases the spores outside. And these spores, when they get the suitable environment, they starts to germinate and produces the new hyphae. This is about the Xylaria. In the next class, I am going to discuss with you about the Puccinia. Thank you.